the pathway, there are, there is no devil. The secret is choosing the right path. The path, the pathway of the righteous. The pathway of the righteous is what we're talking about today. The pathway of the righteous. And to choose the right path. The writer here is Solomon. And Solomon was a great man of God. Said that he was the most wisest man in his day. Thank you, Jesus. Solomon was chosen to be king at an early age. But he had tremendous wisdom and knowledge. Thank you, Jesus. He talks about a variety of different things, and Solomon was extremely rich. Glory to God. He had plenty. But he also understood the pathway of the righteous. He understood the wise and the foolish. He said that 12:15, Solomon 12:15, he said, the way of a fool is right in his own eyes. But he that hearkeneth to counsel is wise. Many times, people is right in their own eyes. The way they see it, but it's not the way you see it. It's what God's word says. Which is our roadmap to heaven. And it's not the way I see it. And some people try to, amen, twist the word of God up and make it sound the way they want it to sound and make it say what they want it to say. Glory to God. But it's not the way you see it. It's not the way you want it to sound. But it's the what God's word says. Thank you, Jesus. And we should try to change it. Bible teaches you if you try to change it, if you try to take away from it, then God will take your name out of the book of life. And apparently people do not believe the Bible or understand it when they try to add to and take away. Just let God's word be as it is. It'll take care of itself. It'll take care of itself. John said, this means that, and that means that. It meant what it said. It says what it meant. In the way of righteousness is life. And in the pathway there is no death. In the pathway of righteousness, there is no death. And then it's talking about eternal death. Eternal death. So I'm saying to you today, it's necessary for you to choose the right path, choose the right direction, choose, glory to God, the direction that you want to go in. I know, glory to God, many times the devil has a lot to offer you. Thank God for the young people, young women, young men, in middle age. The devil has something to offer all of us. And you didn't pass that. Hallelujah. He's got something for you. He's got something to present to you. But the Bible said, what would it profit a man to gain the whole world and lose his soul? Or what would you give in exchange for your soul? Man, I can't go that route. Well, will you exchange it for your soul? You realize you got a soul? There's an eternal part of you, young man, young woman, that never dies, that will live throughout eternity. Whether you believe it or not, that's not going to change it, whether you don't believe whether you believe it or not. It's still going to be there. Bible said Hebrews 13:8, Jesus Christ the same yesterday, today, now, doesn't change. Malachi 3 and 6 said, I'm the Lord God and I change not. Therefore, these sons of Jacob are not consumed. So, what if you don't believe it? According to Romans 3 and 3, I believe. So what if you don't believe God's not going to change his plans because you said, man, I ain't into that. Man, I'm not into that. God got some people that are standing for the truth, and God wants us to caution you and warn you and not to get caught up with what's going on, because believe me, it's a lot going on. Thank you, Jesus. Your schools are not getting any better. They get worse all the time. Amen. Go up there and visit. You're part of the school. You pay your tax, don't you? Go up there and see what's going on. Go to one of their events. Put on whatever you want to put on. Dress just like them. Get right in there with them and you'll see what's going on. It's totally different when you was in school. You better believe that. You go out there to one out there Welcome Stadium and you see what's going on. It'll probably blow your mind. Thank you, Jesus. You don't know. If you're not around them, you don't know what's going on. Okay, what somebody tell you what's reading in a book? If you're not around them, if you don't go in that environment, you don't know what's going on. But it's totally different than it was when you and I was there. It's getting worse all the time. Hallelujah. And it's going to take the power of God to help our people. It's going to take the power of God to save them. But God holds us responsible for preaching and teaching and commanding and pleading and letting his people know the right path. Holds us responsible. Things they do it now, we wouldn't think about doing it when I was in school. Listen, as people have now. Thank you, Jesus. When I was in school, you had to learn how to dance. You had to learn how to dance now. All you do is get out there on the floor. Anybody can dance, that didn't care. Thank you, Jesus. I didn't even learn how when I was in school. But you had to learn how to step in. You had to learn how to put step to things. You don't have to worry about that now. The dance they doing, anybody can do it. All you got to do is go there. Go, but anybody can do it. They don't have to train you. They don't have to teach you. When I was in school, they had to teach you. Thank you, Jesus. The pathway of the righteousness, the pathway. God is calling, hallelujah, and letting us know that there is a righteousness path. That is a way that I want my people to go. Hallelujah to God. The scripture said, I believe in Proverbs 14 and 12, said there's a way that seemeth to be right unto a man, but the end thereof are the ways of death. There is a righteousness path. There is a way that God would have his people to go. Hallelujah. And he's saying to us today, you let somebody open up your understanding. Let somebody preach the word of God to you. Let somebody teach you. Let somebody guide you. Oh, glory to God. Path of the righteous. Path of the righteous. The dictionary defines path as a track, a way worn by footsteps, a walkway used by people on foot. A course that is taken. Thank you, Jesus. You ever been in the forest? You ever been in the fields? They got paths that you go, that you walk in. Thank you, Jesus. There is a path that leads into the right direction, but there are other paths that lead to dead ends. Thank you, Jesus. And it goes that far and it doesn't go any further. Young people, there are times we get on a path, the Lord's preaching right now, the time that we get on the path that leads to a dead end. There are times that we get in the path that it leads to destruction. There's time that we get in the path that leads to failure. Oh, glory to God. But let me advise you very strongly. The Lord has a path for you. There is a pathway of righteousness. There is a pathway of holiness. Glory to God. There is a pathway that leads to eternal life. And God is saying today, it is the way of holiness. It is a way of holiness. Bible said in Hebrews the 12th chapter and the 14th verse, and Father, peace with all men, and holiness without which no man shall see the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. That's the pathway I'm talking about. Holiness is righteousness. Holiness is clean. Holiness is pure. God is holy. And if we expect to spend eternity with God, then we are going to have to be holy too. Give the Lord a hand clap and tell him thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Job 6 and 17 and 18 talked about the path of the wicked. I want to point out to you the path of the wicked first. There's a path that wicked choose to follow. There is a way that wicked people choose to go. Glory to God. There's a certain time in a certain age, it seems like the devil grabs a hold to us and trying to lure you down the wrong path and cause us to do some bad things, cause us to go out into the street, hallelujah, get involved with some things. There is a wicked path that many people go down to, hallelujah. That's, it's wicked and it's destruction. Oh, glory to God, hallelujah. Many, amen, do never find the right way, because when they have a desire to choose the right way, they go in the wrong direction. They choose to follow the wrong crowd. They choose to get with the wrong group. Hallelujah to God. God says, come to church. God says, seek me while I may be found. Oh, glory to God. But they refuse to accept the way of God. They refuse to accept the righteousness path. And they find themselves going in the way of destruction. They find themselves going to the way that leads straight down to hell. But God is saying today, hallelujah, if I were you, as he speak through me today, if I were you, I would choose the path of righteousness. If I were you, I would choose the way of holiness. Glory to God. Let me tell you one thing. Oh, glory to God. Don't miss out on this opportunity. You might not get it again. God said in the word, Matthew 6:33, says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. Amen. You ought to seek God first. Get God on your side first. Hallelujah. You won't have to worry about going in the right direction. If we repent today, if we tell God I'm sorry today, if we, hallelujah, surrender to God today, I want you to know God will come into our life. Oh, glory to God. He will sup with us. He will lead us. He will guide us. He'll give us joy. He'll give us peace and happiness. If I were you, glory to God, I would choose the right. Hallelujah, hallelujah. It talks about the wicked path. Those that rebel against the light, they know not the way. Those that rebel against the light of God, according to Job 2 and 4, 24 and 13, he said, those that rebel against the light, they know not the way, will not abide in the path. Those that rebel against the power of God, those that rebel against the Spirit of the Lord, hallelujah, hallelujah, glory to God, they will not be able to abide in the path of righteousness. They will not be able to make it down the path of righteousness. So that's the reason why God is saying today, he's pleading with his people. Oh, glory to God, on the radio, he's pleading with his people, he's on television, he's pleading with his people on the streets. Oh, hallelujah. He's pleading with them in the schoolhouses. He's pleading with them on the jobs. God got people witnessing on the job. He's got people witnessing in the school. He's got people witnessing on the college campus. He got people witnessing in the university. the Lord our Heavenly Father. Tell her thank you. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And it goes on down to talk about, thank you, Jesus. There in Isaiah 26 and 7, talks about the path of the righteous is just and directed by God. The path of the righteous is just. Hallelujah. But he said it's directed by God. Hallelujah. God is the one that cleans the path. God is the one that opened the door. He's the one that opened the way. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. And the just walks down this path. And the just, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. The just shall live by faith, and the just will exemplify faith. And God is saying today, hallelujah, I recognize the fact the devil will present many offers to us. Oh, glory to God. The devil will present himself in different ways. He's trying to get you where you're from.
Righteousness path.
but I'll let you know that will never be a death. You'll never die. Hallelujah. You might just sleep away from this life on into eternity. Glory to God. But in that second one, so God is saying today, I don't care what kind of song is presented to you.
Deliver from every depression.
Oh, yeah. God is and every disease. And he's saying today, I want you to know, young man, I don't know what kind of path you're on. And I don't know who influenced you to go down that dangerous road. He's saying to you, young lady, I don't know, hallelujah, who influenced you to get my feet. He made a path for me to walk in. Thank you, Jesus. Says made for my feet. Oh, yes. But he's saying to you, oh God, I want you to move from the spirit of Bildad. Ah, yes. Bildad had the wrong spirit. Oh, God. When he began to come up against Job, Lord God, you to move the spirit of Eliphaz. Oh, God. Hallelujah. When you came up against Job, I feel it today. Oh, God. He said Eliphaz had the wrong spirit. Yes, he did. Not along that. He said, I want you to move the spirit of Cain. Oh, God. Cain had the wrong spirit. Oh, God. He thought he could give God whatever he wanted God to have. Sometimes we are like that. I feel like preaching now. Sometimes we think we ought to give God what we want him to have. Oh, yes. God said you ought to do this, and you ought to be faithful. But we said, I got my own agenda. I'm going to do it my own way. God is saying today, get rid of the spirit of Cain. Oh, God. Said the pastor said, do this. Said the pastor said, go this direction. Said the pastor said, but we said, I got my own agenda. And I'm not caring what the pastor said.